John Robert Ochen was attacked by a crocodile on Sunday and his body was recovered today morning. The deceased had gone to fetch water with his twin brother when the unfortunate event happened. The mother of the deceased, Devola Loy Akelo, says she wants government to support her during this trying moment.
Definitely, this is a big loss for us as a family, but I also believe that the government has lost. I only request that the government should be able to support me, should be able to help me with the burial expenses and give me some other support that can make me attend to other people who will be coming for the burial.
The twin brother of the deceased, Joseph Opio, has explained how the events unfolded as they had gone to fetch water.
I was with my brother and we had come to fetch water. He had already fetched two more jerrycans outside from the water source. However, as he went back for another jerrycan, it was now when a crocodile attacked him. As I tried to look around, I could just only see his hand dangling, and the crocodile moved with him deep in the water. I tried to make an alarm for people to come and help me, but nobody could come. And at the end, I had to inform the parents. This was a very sad moment, and that is how we lost him.
The LC5 for Kalaki, Samuel Okelo, has asked Uganda Wildlife Authority to protect the people from such attacks.
This water, you see, we have tried. All the boreholes we have drilled here are salted, they don't drill. So they come here. And then when we fence, we now need to fence several places. Because this is only one place. There are other places there, we need to fence.
The village, you see, if up Wua, the other side.
If Wua can come up with this program, because you should be protecting us from the animals.
Meanwhile, some of the officials of the Uganda Wildlife Authority who visited the scene advised residents to be vigilant as some aquatic animals are a danger to humans.
A lot has talked about the hunting of animals and other injuries extended to the communities by the wild animals, but I do appreciate the communities for having showed the positive attitude. Some of us may not be from this area, but we are also neighbors of protected areas. I felt the impact of these animals to ourselves. Let us follow the appropriate procedure to see that the Ripley family, at least there is no payment for life, but to meet the required costs.
Report compiled by Michael Onyinge for the news.